Before India's independence, irrespective of religion, all Indians were fighting for the independence of India. The freedom struggle included the Hindus, the Muslims, and the Sikhs. In 1940, Muhammad Ali Jinnah made first official demand for Pakistan, that is, an independent state out of India for the Muslims. Influenced by this, some Sikh leaders also demanded for an autonomous state for the Sikhs. And this movement of demanding a separate independent state for the Sikh people was named Khalistan Movement. The Khalistan Movement originally started in early 1940s and 50s, but it became most popular in 1970s and 1980s. Extremists like General Singh Bhindranwale, who was the leader of Damdami Taksal, wanted a separate state out of India for the Sikhs. Damdami Taksal is an educational institute or community of students who associate themselves to a particular saint or prominent spiritual leader. Bhindranwale had a heavy influence on the Sikh youth in Punjab during this time as the leader of the Taksal. Also, Bhindranwale propagated original values of Sikhism and persuaded both young and old to follow the rules and principles of the religion. But besides this, Bhindranwale was a violent and troublesome Sikh preacher. He was accused of allegedly masterminding the killing of Lala Jagat Narayan, who was a newspaper editor and had been exposing Bhindranwale's divisive and communal politics. Also, Bhindranwale was alleged to have killed a rival Sikh preacher, Gurbachan Singh of the Nirankari sect. By May 1984, Bhindranwale and his armed followers were a big problem for the government of Punjab, as a terrorist movement was led by Bhindranwale in Punjab and these militants had taken cover in Sri Harmandir Sahib, that is, in the Golden Temple. Sri Harmandir Sahib is a sacred place for the Sikhs and therefore Bhindranwale knew no one can detain him inside the Gurudwara. Therefore, the then CM of Punjab, Mr. Darbara Singh, went to Lieutenant General S.K. Sinha, who was the commander of the Western Army Command. General Sinha perceived it to be highly inappropriate and he refused, arguing that military must intervene in internal security operations only if the primary instrument of law and order in the state, that is the police, failed to execute their mandate. Darbara Singh appealed to Delhi and the PM, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, realized the spate of killing and a complete breakdown of law and orders in Punjab. The shaken Prime Minister directed her army chief, General Arun Vaidya, to flush Bhindranwale out of Golden Temple. She had little choice but to assign the task to Indian Army, as India did not at the time have a dedicated counter-terrorism force like its current National Security Guards that could have undertaken the very complex mission. General Vaidya immediately assigned the task to the Western Army Command, and General Sinha received a directive from the Vice Chief of Army to plan a military operation to arrest Bhindranwale. And this operation was named Operation Blue Star. Operation Blue Star was divided into two parts, Operation Metal and Operation Woodrose. Operation Metal was limited to Golden Temple, but it also led to Operation Shock, under which the suspects from outskirts of Punjab were captured, while Operation Woodrose was launched throughout Punjab. The operation was carried out by Indian Army using tanks, artillery, helicopter, and armored vehicles. This whole operation was launched to eliminate General Singh Bhindranwale and other Sikh militants who had taken cover in Amritsar's Harmandir Sahib complex. The task of storming the temple was assigned to the four infantry battalions. These were the 9th and 15th Battalion of Kumaon Regiment, 26th Battalion of Madras, 10th Battalion of the Regiment of the Guards. Along with them, a Para Commando Battalion, a battalion from Special Frontier Force, a battalion from Garhwal Rifles, and companies from CRPF and BSF were there. Jarnail Singh Bhindranwale and former Major General Shahbek Singh led the armed Sikhs within the Harmandir Sahib. Major General Shahbek Singh was a court-martialed army officer who was accused of corruption. Therefore, General Shahbek Singh joined Bhindranwale and trained the militants to use weapons. The entire operation lasted for 10 days from 1st of June 1984 to 10th of June 1984. On 1st of June, Guru Ram Das Langar building was attacked by the BSF and CRPF under the orders of the army, in which 11 people died and 25 injured. On 2nd of June, approximately 7 divisions of army were deployed in Punjab. Media faced a blackout and were reportedly put in a military bus and were abandoned at the border of Haryana. The entry of foreigners and NRIs was denied, and in many parts of Amritsar, water and electricity supply was cut off. On 12th of June, Punjab faced a complete curfew as the army and paramilitary were patrolling around, and the Harminder Sahib's entries and exits were completely sealed. On 4th of June, the army started bombarding the historic Ram Gadhia Bungas, the water tank and the fortified positions. The army used Ordnance QF-25 Ponder and achieved the objective of destroying outer defenses laid by General Shah Beg Singh. On 5th of June, shelling started on the building inside the Harminder Sahib complex. Also, Hotel Temple View and Brahmabhuta Akhada on the southwest fringes of the complex was attacked by BSF and CRPF. On 6th of June, due to shelling, the Akal Takht was destroyed and Bhindranwale was killed. On 7th of June, army gained effective control of the Harminder Sahib complex, and from 8th to 10th of June, the army fought about 4 militant Sikhs holed up in a basement of a tower. And finally, by the afternoon of 10th of June, the entire operation was completed by the army. Under Operation Blue Star, the official casualty figure for the army were 83 dead and 249 injured. However, in September 1984, Rajiv Gandhi disclosed that 700 soldiers were killed in this operation. Though Operation Blue Star had left Bhindranwale's secessionist movement in disarray, the army action left a deep psychological impact on the masses. The operation damaged the historical temple and hurted the sentiments of the Sikh community, as they saw military action as an attack on their faith. In order to take revenge, on 31st of October 1984, after 4 months of Blue Star, the then PM Mrs. Indira Gandhi was assassinated by her two Sikh bodyguards, Satwant Singh and Bain Singh. 33 rounds of bullets were fired on her as she ordered the army to attack on Sri Harmandir Sahib. Assassination of Indira Gandhi led to anti-Sikh riots across India. It took place on 1st of November 1984 and continued for a few days, in which around 4,000 Sikhs were killed. After the assassination of Indira Gandhi, the extremist struggle turned into a global movement that troubled India for next few years. On 23rd of June 1985, Air India Flight 182, which was operating on the Montreal-London-Delhi route, was blown up by a bomb at an altitude of 31,000 feet. A total of 329 passengers were killed in this attack. Next year, on 10th of August 1986, General A.S. Vaidya, the 13th Army Chief who supervised the Operation Blue Star, was shot dead in Pune after his retirement. By the year 1986, again some extremists started taking shelter in Sri Harmandir Sahib, but they were easily neutralized by the Operation Black Thunder in two phases, first in 1986 and second in 1988. Operation Black Thunder was a success as it was completed over a night, with no harm to the Golden Temple and to the civilians. In May 1988, after second phase of Black Thunder, the government swing into action as the Golden Temple was once again turned into fortress, and by mid-1990s, Punjab was back on the track.